Hello friends, in this video we are going to discuss reduced row echelon form. It is a form of matrix which satisfy the following conditions. First condition, there is a zero row, then it should at the bottom of the matrix. So here we have zero row, it should at bottom of the matrix, that means there is no non-zero below this zero row. So it should be in this form, then it satisfies the condition. Then there is a no non-zero below this zero row. Second condition, if there is a non-zero, then first non-zero entry should be one which is called the leading one of the row. So we have first three non-zero, then the green star entry are the leading entries because row start from left to right. This first non-zero entry should be 1 and which is called the leading one of the row. Third condition, if there is a two consecutive non-zero, then below row should have more zero than the above row before leading one. So we have 3 consecutive non-zero. In the first row there is a 0-0 before the leading one. In the second row there is a 2-0 before the leading one. And in the third row there is a 1-0 before the leading one. So by the condition, first and second row satisfy the condition because below row is second row which has 2-0 which is more than the first row because first row is 0-0 before the leading one. And the second and third row has 1-0 before the leading one and second row has 2-0 before the leading one. So this two row does not satisfy the condition and it should in this position then it satisfy the condition number 3. Now condition 4, in the column of leading one all other entries should be 0 except the leading one. So we have 3 column of leading one. Then in the first column except the leading one all the entries are 0. In the second and third column this star entries and this star entry should be 0. Then it satisfy the fourth condition. And a matrix will satisfy all the four condition. It is in the reduced row echelon form. Now example, is the following matrix is in the reduced row echelon form? So we are going to check one by one condition. First condition, there is a zero row should at the bottom, but there is a non-zero below the zero row, therefore it does not satisfy the first condition and hence the matrix not in the reduced row echelon form. Example number 2, first condition, zero row should at the bottom. Correct, it satisfy the first condition. Leading one concept. So first non-zero as leading one. Second non-zero, first non-zero entry is 1. So it satisfy the condition. In the third row, first non-zero entry is 2 in place of 1. So it does not satisfy the condition. And the second condition is violated. Therefore, A is not in the reduced row echelon form. Example number 3. First condition, zero row should at the bottom. Correct. Second condition, leading one. So first row begin with the leading one. Second row, first non-zero entry is 1. And the third row, first non-zero entry is 1. So satisfy the second condition. Third condition, for 2 consecutive non-zero, second row has more zero than the first row. First, second and third row. So in the first row, 0-0 before the leading one. In the second row, 1-0 before the leading one. And in the third row, 0-0 before the leading one. So first and second row satisfy that the below row has more zero than the above row. But in the second and third row has 0-0s. And the second row has 1-0, so it does not satisfy the third condition, and hence this matrix is not in the reduced row echelon form. Fourth example, first condition, zero row should at the bottom, correct. Second condition, leading one, yes, first, second and third row begin with the leading one. Third condition, two consecutive non-zero. So first row as 0, 0, second row as 1, 0 and the third row as 2, 0 before the leading one. Therefore, they satisfy the third condition. Now the fourth condition, in the column of leading one, all the entries 0 except the leading one. So in the first column, all the entries are 0 except the one. In the second and third column, we have 1 and minus 1. They are non-zero entries. Therefore, they does not satisfy the fourth condition. Hence, this matrix is not in the reduced row echelon form. Example number 5. First condition, 0 row should at the bottom, which is correct. Leading 1, which is also correct. Before the leading one, there is a more zero in the below row. So for the first, second and third row, 0, 0s in the first row, 1, 0 in the second row, and 2, 0 in the third row before the leading one, and they satisfy the third condition. Fourth condition, in the column of leading one, other entry should be 0. So we have 3 columns with the leading one. First column, all the entries are 0. Second column, all the entries are 0, and the third column, all the entries are 0 except the leading one. Therefore, fourth condition is also satisfied by the matrix, and hence it is in the reduced row echelon form. Thanks for watching. For more videos, like, share, subscribe, press the bell icon of NextGenMaths.